What is up, people? Back for another question and answer video. This is Q&A number 16. As usual, if you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to hit that like button and leave a comment below, and I will talk to you guys later. Peace. What is up, people? Back for another question and answer video, Q&A number 16. I am ready for this. I feel good. I'm moist. It's 6:14 in the morning. I don't know why I'm not asleep, but I'm just in that productive kind of mood. If you're new here, Q&A videos is your opportunity to get your question displayed on the screen and a personal answer from the legendary one himself. You're happy that I answered your question. I'm happy that I got to answer your question, and everybody's happy. If at any time you want to see the past Q&A videos 1 through 15, there's an annotation in the top left of the screen. Make sure to click that after this video and check out all the questions that you may or may not have missed. And without further ado, let's jump into the first question. Question number 1 by Ryan Garay. How do you keep yourself from being toxic? Being toxic is something that you're just gonna have to deal with when you play multiplayer online games. What I've just learned to do, honestly, is walk away. There's no point on being upset over a video game, and when you do actually get to that point, you need to take a break. Usually, if the game is bothering you that much, you need to walk away. You've been playing too much, or it's just not the environment that you have to be in for a long amount of time. So whenever I personally feel like I'm getting toxic, disrespectful, rude, I'll pretty much just do something else. That's the best thing to do, really. Because regardless, if you keep coming back to the same thing that's pissing you off, it's gonna piss you off again. That's just how it works. So I like to take breaks, you know? You'll notice that nowadays, after playing League of Legends for 3 years, I don't play the game every single day like I used to in previous seasons. And that's just to keep me refreshed, happy, and whatever may happen in that game that may actually upset me won't bother me as much because I've built up tolerance by taking breaks. Question number 2 by Rudy Martinez. Your thoughts on gaming today compared to back in the day? I feel a little biased answering this question, but I'm pretty sure that a lot of people who have played video games for over a decade or more kind of understand that video games back in the day are a lot better than they are now. I think the reason behind that is because games back in the day were made to promote the gaming industry as a whole. Like, they wanted to get games out there in the spotlight to show that games are worth investing in, both for fun and for business. And all they really wanted to do was push an industry. They weren't really focused on the money, because regardless, if you make a video game, you're gonna get the money. You know, you make the video game, people buy it. That's just how it works. That's business. That's society that we live in. So when you remove the money from a creation, you put a lot more effort into the life of the characters inside of the video game, into the story. You put more effort into the things that matter. And nowadays, I feel like video games are made strictly for the money. And it kind of shows, because when Dota and League of Legends got popular, especially League, because Dota has been around for a while, but especially when League got popular, there were so many spin-off MOBAs that came out, even on iDevices like my iPhone. There's like 20 different MOBAs for your iPhone, and none of them are good, but they keep on making them, right? And I feel like the only reason they're doing that is because the genre is popular. You know, League of Legends is the newest MOBA to really take over. You have Smite, you have Dota, but people keep making it because it's profitable. So I would honestly say that games in the past are a lot better than they are today because a lot more work was put into what actually mattered rather than making the money. Question number 3 by Demetrius Irvin James Baldwin. Give me points for that one. Girls wearing slutty Halloween costumes. You like it? Or is it overdone? Honestly, it's overdone. I don't want to put a negative light on Halloween. It is my favorite time of the year. I like the idea behind Halloween and everything, but the girls that constantly, year after year, dress up as a slutty nurse or a half-naked cat, I feel like those girls completely shat on Halloween as a whole. Like, I know ladies are growing up and they want to look sexy 24/7, blah, 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 but you just got to understand that regardless, you are sexy 24/7. You are a woman. You don't need to use Halloween as an excuse to try and impress everyone else. You do it 24/7. Whatever happened to the witch? Whatever happened to the bloody zombie? You know, whatever happened to Freddy Krueger and the Ring Girl? That's what Halloween is all about. That's personally what I honestly believe. Ladies, if you're gonna go as the sexy police officer one more time, I might just rage quit life. You don't need to try so hard, or try so little, I should say. You're beautiful. You don't need Halloween to prove it. Go as like the Grim Reaper or something. I want to be scared, okay? I want to be scared. Question number 4 by Joy Webster. Are people who didn't like you in the past now nice to you because you're fame on YouTube? I don't really talk too much about what I do on YouTube. Of course, there's people that know me personally that know what I do on YouTube, but it's not like I'm walking around saying, hey, I'm on YouTube, I have over 160,000 subs. Like, I don't really brag about what I do. I never really have. I'm just kind of happy that I have it and hope that I get more. But for those that have known me personally before YouTube and know me now, whether I keep in touch with them or not, there has been little changes here and there. Mostly what I've seen, honestly, is jealousy. I actually had a couple scenarios of people not really liking the success, you know, because sometimes people just like you because you're not doing anything like them. You know how you just sometimes get into that state in life where you're just hanging out every day, not really doing anything, just enjoying it day by day. And there's nothing wrong with that. But the minute you decide to get up and do something, whether it's, you know, go to university or get a job or make a job in my case, whenever you get in a scenario like that, people will often change their opinion of you. And it's usually not in a positive light for some odd reason. I don't know what it is. But it hasn't been anything game breaking. It hasn't like made me feel like a negative person or anything like that. It's just something that happens, you know. But overall, I haven't really encountered anything that really made me want to reconsider YouTube or anything like that. It's all been good. I've met a lot of people through this that are genuinely nice people. And the small amount of people that have a problem with it, I don't really concern myself with. Question number 5 by Luis Ramirez. If you could make a skin for one champion, what champion and what skin would you do? This is really easy. I'm going to keep it simple. I've even taken the time to design this quality splash image of the champion and the skin that I would like to see in League of Legends. It's pretty simple, but I would like to see an Ezreal Ash Ketchum skin where instead of throwing beams of light, he throws Pokeballs. And when he kills the enemy, there's a Pokeball animation of the enemy champion being caught. Now tell me that isn't cool. I don't know anything about his ultimate. I haven't really thought that far, honestly. Maybe you guys can just fill in the blanks. But I think that if I were to throw my Q as Ezreal and catch an enemy champion when I kill them, that would be amazing. Question number 6 by Daniel Martin Huff. When did Annie become your daughter? You're not the first person to ask me this question within the past week, and honestly, I can't even remember. Annie is just like a part of my daily life now. Like, I love that little girl. She's like the little girl that I don't have and don't want anytime soon. But honestly, I think it was sometime in season 3 I was going through my Nidalee phase where I was calling Nidalee my waifu because she was OP and every game that I had with Nidalee was top notch, you know, YouTube worthy. And then one day I was like, wait, I have to complete the family. I have to play real life Sims. If I have Nidalee and Nidalee is my waifu, then where's the little girl, you know? Because when I get older, when I feel like it's time to settle down officially and bring a human into this world, I always pictured that it would be a little girl. I don't picture myself having a son. I want a daughter. I want a cute little doll walking around and calling me daddy, you know? I feel like that's a good experience. So naturally, the only little girl in the game is Annie. So it kind of just goes hand in hand and Annie became the daughter. Nidalee was the waifu, now she's the ex-waifu, but I keep Annie. I have custody of Annie because I love that little girl. Question number 7 by Yusha Yang. If you are a Call of Duty fan or not, what do you think of Call of Duty Advanced Warfare?
Oh my goodness.
That's pretty much what I think. Question number 8 by Malaki David. What's your favorite thing about League of Legends, bro? I think where League of Legends really shines is in the characters. I've talked about this before in the past when comparing League of Legends to Dota 2. And I feel like where League of Legends stands undefeated and where it could never get a rival is in its character development. Their characters have life. They're characters with simple names for the most part that you can remember, which is really effective. Naming a character Caitlyn instead of Drowranger is a lot better for the community to actually remember and relate to. But the fact that I know someone named Caitlyn and the fact that someone in League of Legends is named Caitlyn, it kind of makes it easier to remember. The fact that someone is named Darius instead of Bloodseeker, you know? You can relate to the characters a lot more. And the characters kind of come to life whenever you're playing the game. I think that's what I really like about League of Legends the most. They have skins that add a lot more personality depending on what the skin is based off of. And that's just where Riot Games and League of Legends shines. I don't think any MOBA is ever gonna beat League of Legends in terms of character development because what they've put together is just so well done. Question number 9 by Michael Sanchez. What rank are you and how long did it take you to achieve it? At the moment, I think I'm gold 2 or 3. It literally took a week of playing ranked. I placed in like silver 3 or 4. And then within like a short amount of time, I quickly got up to gold 2. And then I decayed to gold 3. And now they got rid of decay. Thanks, Rito. But I only wanted the season end rewards like the Morgana skin, the Ward skin, the border, etc. It's really easy to achieve rank in this game. That's what a lot of people don't understand. They get wrapped up in all the extra stuff and the entertainment side of League of Legends, and they don't quite understand exactly what ranked is. At the end of the day, ranked is no different from normal play. And if you want to climb ranked, and even if you want to win normal play, you gotta play what you're best at. For example, I went from Silver 3 all the way to Gold 2 in less than a week by only playing AD carry and mid. Those are my two strongest roles. Jungle, not really too good. Top is my worst role. I don't like playing support. I feel like I could do more in another role than play support. So whenever I got the chance, I would call mid or ADC, and most of the time I would get it. If you enter champion select and you make it clear that those are your strongest roles, like don't just say ADC and mid, say I'm best with ADC and mid. Make it clear to the people that you've been matched up with that this is what you're good at, and if we're gonna win, we're gonna win because it's me getting one of these roles, and vice versa for other people. If other people tell you the same thing, don't take it away from them. That is how you're gonna get along with these people, and that is how you're gonna win a ranked match. If for some reason you're last pick and you don't get what you want, you can either deal with it if you feel like the other people on your team can handle the roles, or honestly, you can dodge. You lose a lot less dodging than actually playing out a match that you don't feel comfortable in and losing. You gotta kind of weigh your options and figure out what's the better option to take. So once you pretty much nail that down, once you get some roles that you understand, and once you put the time in, no matter how long it takes, that's actually irrelevant. You know, you take as long as you need to take, but if you follow this method, if you play what you're good at, if you try and be friendly with the people on your team, then you'll achieve your goal in no time. It really is simple. Question number 10 by Cooper J. Wagner. What's a good way to start a YouTube channel? Honestly, it's different for every single person. I usually don't answer this question because there is no answer. Despite what you may see on YouTube, a lot of people like to make videos teaching you how to get subscribers and whatnot, but they can only tell you what worked for them. And I've even seen videos of people with no subscribers trying to teach people how to get subscribers. It's really weird. I don't understand why people think there's a method. All you gotta do is literally choose your name, log in, and present yourself to people. There is no other method. All I can really say to you is don't try to be anybody but yourself, number one. You know, we already have this person here, so why are you gonna try and mimic them? Be yourself. It's kind of like the same advice I would give someone who's worried about high school. You know, be yourself. Who cares what other people think? If people can't accept you for you, then that's their problem, not yours. You should not mold yourself to appeal to other people. They should appreciate you for who you are. Put some time into it. Learn how to do things yourself. Don't always ask other people. You know, it's kind of like school in a way. YouTube is really like school. If you want to pass, you got to learn. If you want to learn, you got to do your research. You got to investigate. If you want people to appreciate you, you got to appreciate yourself. You got to be confident, so on so forth. Do the work, upload the videos. If it happens, it happens. If it doesn't, it doesn't. That's pretty much all it is. So that is Q&A number 16. Thank you guys for watching. If you have any questions that you would like to see in the next Q&A, Q&A number 17, make sure to leave them in the comment section below. Again, if you want to see any of the past Q&A videos to see any questions that you may or may not have missed, click the annotation in the top left. If you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to hit that like button and leave a comment below, and I will talk to you guys later. Peace. Now put your hands up. Now put your hands up. Now put your